This is the Rich Dad Radio Show. The good news and bad news about money. Here's Robert Kiyosaki.
Hello, hello, hello. It's Robert Kiyosaki, the Rich Dad Radio Show. The good news and bad news about money. And we have some really good news for you today. I mean, today we have the man with the plan, the man with the on the hour. I mean, I cannot think of a guy. I mean, it's just stunning. What? Just stay tuned. You're going to be blown away. Any comments, Kim?
Yeah, we have a very special guest. And, you know, everybody has podcasts out there. Everybody's forming a new podcast. They're all becoming superstars. But we've got the expert here on podcasts. He's Jeffrey Hazlett. He's chairman CEO of C-Suite Network. And just to be transparent, we are with C-Suite on our podcast, and they've done tremendous things for us. And we were very excited to have Jeffrey on the program because everybody's got a podcast. And what makes one podcast stand out from another podcast? That's one of the questions I want to explore, as well as a wealth of other information, because Jeffrey is quite the business guy, and we love our entrepreneurs.
And he's been with our friend Donald Trump on The Celebrity, and he is the entrepreneur serial. He's always going. He doesn't stop. But I think most importantly of all that, you know, we used to do this stuff for free. And now because of Jeffrey, we're making a lot of money, you know. And so that's even the best thing about the whole thing, because we're Rich Dad's a pure education company. We don't endorse or sell, you know, vitamin pills and stuff like that. I mean, personally. But we were just doing this to
get the information out.
Information. Mm-hmm. And now it's one of our biggest revenue sources. So the reason I'm absolutely in love with Jeffrey Hazlett is because we were rich, but now we're richer. That's even the better part. So I want you guys all to pay attention, because this is the man with the plan right now. Welcome to the show, Jeffrey.
Welcome, hey, Jeffrey.
Thank you so much. You know what's even better about that? You're getting richer, so am I.
There we go. That's
benefit.
That's
and isn't that
be.
The cool thing is whenever you can have mutual benefit, it's equal benefit. We both bring strength to the table. I mean, you bring great reputation, great advice. You bring a great following. You're one of our very top, you know, headliners in the C-Suite Radio, which is our podcast network. And when you see that, and then I'm able to also on top of that make money. Oh my gosh, I want more of that. I want more.
So Jeffrey, tell us your story. Tell us the highlights.
Well, you know, I've been in the business world for a number of years. I've been an entrepreneur. I've bought and sold hundreds of businesses for billions of dollars. And I ended up being a Fortune 100 officer, Fortune 50 officer, in fact, at Eastman Kodak. And then went on to, do my own television show on Bloomberg. And then started the podcast network at CBS. They got out of the business. I took it and said, let's create C-Suite Radio. And now we have C-Suite TV, C-Suite Radio, C-Suite Book Club, C-Suite Legal, C-Suite Supplies. Jeez. I mean, we over 100 different products that our product lines or IP that came out of just that inner exchange and journey. And now I sit on, 14 corporate boards. Three of those are public companies. The rest are all private. Most of those I have now purchased a significant place inside of them. But, you know, I've served on boards like DocuSign and other companies that we've taken public, which was, you know, a massive stock rise, you know, $21 billion when it went public. So, yeah, just being at the right place at the right time. But, it's a little more than that. It's always been making sure you're at the right place at the right time.
Right. So with C-Suites, owned by CBS? I mean, was it CBS product?
No. So when I did my show on Bloomberg, I started a show and called it The C-Suite with Jeffrey Hazlett, where I took people into the boardrooms of the C-Suite where they were making massive decisions. So, why would Domino's change its name from Domino's Pizza to Domino's? And why would they run a commercial that says our pizza suck? You know, so I would go in there and say, who made that decision and what was that about and what was the result? Well, their stock went from 70 cents to now trading at over $121 a share as a result of just that campaign. And so when you see things like that, I want to know what that, you know, what made them, you know, who raised their hand and said, no, we suck and we suck so bad. We should change our name and we should redo our pizza and we should do things differently. And so I took people in. As a result of that success of that show on Bloomberg, which became the number one business show at the time. Now, you know, we say that, how many people rush out to watch a primetime business show? Doesn't happen, right? And what happened was we started seeing people who are watching it more online than we're watching it on broadcast. Wow. And the sales team was giving it away. And I'm going, what are you doing? Why are you giving this show away? Are you giving away the inventory? And so I said, we've got to create a digital network. And Bloomberg wasn't interested. So I quit. And after one season, I quit and I started C-Suite Network and I started C-Suite TV and then started C-Suite Radio and going to where the people were and capturing behavior. Because if you capture behavior, you capture money and you capture, you know, great revenues and audiences and tribes and everything else that comes with it. So that's how it came about. And to be real blunt, we were calling it the CEO Network until the night before we launched. And I said, you know, we really should call this thing a C-suite. Why should we just focus on CEOs? Why don't we focus on all the VPs, all the people in the C-suite? There's usually five of them as opposed to one CEO. We can make more money. It's 5X. And they said, oh, well, C-suite's probably taken. Well, we went on GoDaddy, looked it up. No one had it. And I said, switch it. And we redid the artwork in less than a half an hour. We called our ad agency and said, hey, I want the CEO Network switched out to C-Suite Network. And they said, why? I said, don't ask why, just do it. And they did it. And we launched it the next day. That was a history. And now we've got business that's worth multi-millions of dollars.
You know? What year was that? You made that?
This was about 2015.
Jeez.
So we've, you know, now we have 350,000, you know, opt-in members, tens of thousand paid members. And then of course, millions who listen to your show, millions that listen to other shows that we've got. And of course our TV is hitting, you know, like 90 million a month. And, you know, we're on United Airlines, we're in hotel rooms, I am going wherever anyone can listen or see us or read us. That's what I want to do.
So I'm curious, Jeffrey, when you talked about Kodak, because Kodak is kind of a classic business story in the world of digital and all of this. When you were at Kodak, were you there to turn it around? What were the lessons you got out of Kodak?
Yeah, I was there from 2006 to 2010. So okay. I was part of the team that came in to see what we could do to salvage whatever was there. Because, you know, for years they built a product, which is one of the best products in the world based on memories, but they did it on film. So they believed they were a film company, and they were never a film company. If you really think about it, they were in the emotional technology business is what they were in. And they should have transitioned that into digital. They invented the digital camera. They just put it on a shelf and said, you know, don't mess with the film, thinking film was the one thing. And so that hubris of that success was really tough, you know, and it's tough to turn around a business when everybody says, well, our best days are behind us. If you believe your best days are behind you, it's really tough to change the mood of a company. Yeah. You know, you can talk about culture, but really it's mood. And first you got to affect the mood and then you can affect the culture. But, and that's a tough thing to do. So yeah, I was there and, you know, and what's left, you know, is the stuff that we brought and changed and put in, which makes the company still viable. It's a good buy right now, quite frankly. It's a really good buy, in my opinion, because they got more cash in the bank than what the company is worth. Yeah.
Well, so sounds like GameStop to me. But anyway, anyway, would you mind telling us how big this podcast business is and what you see is happening? And
well, a lot of people think, you know, right now they're seeing so many which podcasts. They say, I've already missed it. Are you kidding me? If we were to look at podcasting as a human being, we're still in the young teenagers, right? In terms of where we're at, there's roughly 230,000 podcasts in North America, millions worldwide, and about 150 million people listening every single day. So it's a massive, massive movement, and it's going to only get bigger. And so when you look at that today, there's only about $9 billion being spent in advertising in this marketplace. That's going to have a massive shift in the next couple of years. And so for anyone who wants to, you know, become a brand, be a brand, which is nothing but a promise delivered, and everybody should, if you work for the company, you are the company, the company's you, that's the way you want to be able to do this. And it helps you, helps I, helps a lot of people build that brand. And this is a really credible way because you're on the phone. I mean, think about this. The most personal device in the history of the world is the phone. I mean, you know where your phone is more than you know where your children are. I mean, think about it. You know, you lose your kids and your phone at the mall at the same time. Which one will you go looking for first? Right? So podcasting is massive. And for B2B or B2C, but B2B, I mean, it's still in its very infancy days in terms of being at the beginning. You know, the average business podcast is between 22 and 25 minutes. I can tell you, you know, which devices they download them on, which ones are most popular, and, you know, all of the things that are really important that you can get because it's a digital medium and it's in it and you're in someone's head. You guys know that people write to you all the time, you know?
Yeah. So let's start with somebody who doesn't have anything going for them right now. I was just with my cardiologist this morning talking to him at breakfast, and I said, you know, people would pay a fortune for what you know.
Oh yeah.
I mean, totally. You know, and not only is he a cardiologist, he's an acupuncturist. So he's East and West.
Yeah.
And I said, if you did a show on health, he goes, well, how do I do that?
All you need is a mic, maybe a headset, and an internet connection, you know? And
so how does somebody like him, his name is Radha, how does he get himself known? Because there's so much information out there.
That's a great question, because if you're not part of a network, you're in podcast purgatory. Right. I mean, because there are, you know, there's 1800 different, outlying broadcast networks to put it to. How would you know which one? Obviously, Apple, obviously, you know, Stitcher, all these different ones are really important. Spotify, those are critical, but there's a lot more and you got to go where people are. So first thing is find another expert, find people that you would admire, respect, or find people that Robert admires or respects, because that's how, you know, we all learn. And you want to, you know, go to your friends first, and so see where your friends are at and see where they're at, and then your domain in terms of, you know, he might want to look more for a medical, but you know, we would love to have somebody like that on C-Suite Radio because it's a, you know, it's lifestyle, health, you know, luxury. We want all those, right?
And that's one of the beauties of what you do is you connect people to other networks, correct?
Without question, you either connect you to other networks and we'll help you get started. So, you know, at C-Suite Radio, we have a startup package. We have teams that can do it. We have producers. You have in-house producers, and because you're so big and, you know, and so successful at what you do. So you've got full-time team members who do that, and they're the best at what they do. I happen to know your team. They're really good. And not everybody has that resource. So outsource the resource. You know, I had Dan Burris, on the show here recently, on my show, All Business with Jeffrey Islin on C-Suite Radio. And I had him on my show, and he talked about X as a service. I said, what the hell does X as a service mean? And he goes, well, why do you have to do it? You can find others to do it for you. You've got a heart problem, go to cardiologists. You got a muffler problem, call Midas. You know, and you don't, you, so go find those people to do it. But it's easy to do. There's startup packages. It's easy to figure out how to do it. And by the way, unlike you or I, Robert, in terms of your show, right, you have tons and tons of downloads. I have tons and tons of downloads. We're in the top one half of 1% of success in podcast worldwide. I don't even know if you knew the extent of how popular you are. That's how good it is. This is not a game of what we call eyeballs and ears. This is a game about hearts and minds. This is a game about building your tribe, about, you know, getting to people who really want great. And need the information.
That's great. Yeah. That is fantastic. Thank you. And then naturally, I got to ask, what's the revenue model?
Well, the revenue model is most people want to use the business podcast. Let's use B2B because most people aren't going to be famous. We want to go for fortune. All right. If we're going to go for fortune, how do you use the podcast? Not as a destination, All right. Because a lot of people think, oh, I'm a speaker. I'm an author. No, no, no. Those are just tools for you to use to get what you want. And right. So podcasting is one of those. So the revenue model is to have people on your show that you want to do business with, or to be able to educate and motivate and inspire those that listen to you to get what they want and need, which is a lot of what you do.
And you know what I like, Jeffrey, is in the old days, we had to promote and get on the phone and beg to be on TV shows and please get me on. And we get on for like four minutes. Robert's on for like 2-3 minutes. But here we get to educate. We get to get our message out.
Yeah.
It's free publicity.
Yeah, we put a nickel in and we put on a show. I mean, that's basically what we're doing. And we do it the way we want to. It doesn't mean it's right or it's wrong, but it's what we want to do.
Right.
Exactly.
And I think that's what's really cool about this medium.
So once again, it's Robert Kiyosaki, the Rich Dad Radio Show. Our guest today is the man of the man with the plan, the man of the hour, Jeffrey Haslett. He's chairman and CEO of the C-Suite Network. And for all of you out there who want to be rock stars or get your message out, you have no idea how hard it was getting PR and an audience and eyeballs or ears, what do you want to say, from the old days. So you guys, please pay attention. This is probably one of the, if you're an entrepreneur or do you want to be an entrepreneur, this is the man you want to listen to. So we'll be right back. Welcome back, Robert Kiyosaki, the Rich Dad Radio Show, the good news and bad news about money. And today we have some of the best news I've heard in a year. Some of the very best news. Plus, I'm getting rich. So it makes me even happier. So you can listen to the Rich Dad Radio Show anytime, anywhere at iTunes, Android, and YouTube. And then all of our programs are archived at richdadradio.com. We archive it for only one reason. We are a pure education company. We don't recommend stocks or investments and all this. But we want you to learn more. So if you listen to this program again, you'll pick up twice as much. So listen to this program with our guest today, Jeffrey Haslett, CEO and chairman of C-Suite Network. Just go to richdadradio.com, download it, listen to it. But most important, if you have friends, family, and business associates, listen to this podcast again and discuss it. Your education, what you'll learn, will go quantum. Because, you know, that's how we learn, by cooperating with each other. So our guest today is Jeffrey Haslett, chairman and CEO of C-Suite Network.
And what C-Suite is, for those of you who do not know, C-Suite is the home of the fastest growing business podcast network. So if you have a podcast, if you're thinking about starting a podcast, this is the show for you.
One quick question may complete this. So if somebody, like my doctor, Dr. Rado Gopal, is a cardiologist, acupuncturist, he's very much into the East and West medicine. If he wanted to get started, what could he contact you guys?
Absolutely. Just reach out to me, Jeff Haslett. There's my, and if you're watching right now, you can see my email, but jeff@csuitenetwork.com, csuitenetwork.com.
That'd be fantastic.
Yeah, we'll put them together. And we have packages for them to be able to start a podcast, or if you're already doing a podcast and you've got it on another network and you don't want to be lost in podcast purgatory, let's bring it over, you know, to a network where you can be found. Otherwise, you're just going to be wandering in the desert. I mean, that's truly what happens. You got to hope someone finds you. And, you know, we're in, like, for instance, even your own show, as popular as you are, we're helping you to increase. We're helping you monetize. I mean, your team has told me we made you more money the last 3 months than you made the last 3 years.
Even more than that, Jeffrey, is it was costing us a fortune doing it ourselves. Yeah, and totally. We weren't reaching as many people, and we were losing money, a lot of money, putting this out
money.
Because we wanted to get the education out as soon as we work with you guys, a startup,
it's this less zeros. You're making more zeros. They have less zeros, but we'll get them there. And that's what it's all about. It's, you know, C-Suite Radio and C-Suite Network is a place for people to come and trust an environment to be able to take their content and grow the business. That's really, truly what we are.
And then,
so we're a network.
And then I'll, for testimony, they do what they talk about. I mean, we've made more money with these guys than anybody else. And we were losing money before. And we were pretty popular in the real world. And we're still losing money. But until we went with Jeffrey Haslett and the C-Suite Network, it changed our business model. It blew me away.
And it made it so much easier. Oh, my gosh, so much easier.
Yeah. Yep. So I want to go into a politically incorrect and hot topic right now. And
I love that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you're a friend of Donald Trump. He's one of my really great friends and all this. Yep. And I want to talk about censorship. But more than censorship is, in my opinion, and this is my humble opinion, those socialists out of Silicon Valley took down the president.
And, well, without a question, they made an impact. And let me tell you, While you know, Trump's a friend of mine, okay? Yeah. I think he's, you know, somewhat batshit crazy. I'd say that, and I tell him that when I talk to him, right? But nonetheless, you have no one has a right in this country to censor anyone, period. Yep. I mean, we're a network. I have C-suite TV, I have C-suite radio. I have to look at objectionable content from time to time. Now, I might call up the show host and have a conversation, all right? But I'm not censoring their material. Okay. I might choose in a long term. I might say, hey, look, it just doesn't fit us or that, but no one has the right in this country to censor anyone. That's given to us. And that's the hallmark, the fabric of what we've got. So, and when someone says, yeah, but it was him, listen, my friends, let me ask you, if for anyone that hears or says that right now, let me take away your Twitter account. Let me take away your voice, and you can't respond. You can't say something, and then you tell me that, because that's indeed what they could do. And if you look at it from that perspective, no one in their right minds would say that's acceptable. In fact, it's bullshit. It's real bullshit. And I just think we should be more up in arms about that, regardless of who said what or what they said or how nuts they may be. You know, I might not like when a football player takes a knee, but I will defend his or her, you know, right to do it. I might not like someone who burns the flag, but I will defend their right to do it, because that's what this Constitution says.
So let me ask you this question. What's the future then? Because, you know, I'm afraid to tweet because they come after me.
Good. Well, you get some more publicity. Don't be afraid to tweet, right? If nothing else, we'll get better publicity. We'll have better things that'll come out of it.
But so what's going to happen, Jeffrey? I mean, you know, you're a demographics guy. Yeah. I think there's anger just building up like we've never seen before. I mean, how dare they do that?
Well, I think it creates other platforms for people to go to. I mean, look at what's happened. You've seen the ultra-right move over to Parler. You've seen other ones starting to pop up. Some of the other fringe social media platforms are going to pop. I think it's going to give us more credence for not just shows like this. You know, where I'm actually thinking we should call a show called No Slant. And meaning it has no slant on anything. It just reports things the way they are. You know, good, bad, or ugly, just like you do.
So let me ask this question. Are you concerned if they took off Parler?
Yeah.
Are you concerned they come after C-Suite?
Well, give it a shot. But I'll go find another place, another way to be able to broadcast if that were the case. No, it depends on where the bulk of your content is, of whether or not it'll make you a target, in my opinion. You know, anyone could be a target. Obviously, it's a slippery slope. I think I'm a little bit more safe because the most controversial thing I might have is I got a cannabis show or two, and I've got 23 legal shows, and I've got a divorce show. And, you know, those are the extent of our C-suite network's radical right or left. So we tend to be more about business, and you can't make that too radical, you know, other than driving change.
And aren't podcasts an alternative to all of this other social media that's going on? People can say what they want to say.
Yeah, I think most people are going to have to find trusted media. And I think that's the thing that we're in right now is who can I trust? You know, you see a headline. Where is it coming from? Was it a Russian hacker that put it out there? Was it the Chinese? Was it, you know, or was it just my neighbor who's pretending like he's somebody that has those credentials? That's why I think trusted networks. That's why we believe the C-Suite Network, C-Suite Radio, C-Suite TV is an important piece of that, because we are making sure we know the people who do that and how they do it, the way they do it. And they live by a certain code. And if you don't have that, then we're in trouble. And some of that's broken down. I mean, you've got people who are saying they're influencers on Instagram with 2 million followers. Then she puts out, you know, hey, go buy this T-shirt. And only two people buy the T-shirt. That's not an influencer. That's a de-influencer, right? you got people who are going out there at 19 years old saying they're life coaches. You're not a life coach. You are a team coach. Let's be clear. You're a team coach. And that's what we have to go fight through. And I think, you know, we see, and you've seen this, Robert, we have been in this business for a long, long time. And we've been in the business of trust. And there's a lot of people out there who are false prophets.
Yes.
Oh God.
Yes. Yeah. And you and I see them. We see it all the time. I see them. Oh, how to make $1 million on stage. How did, you know, and this guy's never even walked on a stage, you know, much less, you know, and we know all the, you and I know all the people who are making $1 million or more on stage. We know that. It's a very small group worldwide. Same thing with podcasters who tell me they've got millions and millions of downloads. Oh, you're nuts. No way. You know, because I can go see the numbers and know what they've got. So let's cut through the bullshit. Let's cut through the crap and let's get to real stuff and make, you know, and do it the right way. That's what I like to do.
That's a really good point about trusted, because we talk about fake teachers and real teachers, and we only want to deal with real teachers, not fake teachers. So
exactly. Yeah. Go to people who've done it. I mean, that's the best way you can do it. Yeah. And, you know, it's like in the C-suite, you know, billion-dollar companies like to hang out with billion-dollar companies. Why? Because they know what their problems are. You know, it doesn't mean you can't transcend that. You just have to show that the zeros that you're doing down here can go to those zeros up there. And so what we try to do is look at the roles and then look at the way in which we apply those roles inside that C-suite.
Well, the thing I want to say to all you entrepreneurs or wannabe entrepreneurs or entrepreneurs just started, what Jeffrey Hasler is talking about with C-suite is a gift from heaven. You know, I mean, I'm so old, I remember flying from Hawaii to New York, hoping to get an appointment in New York. I get off the, you know, we fly from Hawaii to Chicago. I have a pocket full of quarters. I kind of run out during the, you know, while they're refueling, whatever they're doing. I got to pump all these quarters into the machine, into the payphone. And they say, he's busy. Don't talk to him now. I'm going, and then I got to climb back on the plane, get to New York, and then I got to pay $9 million for a hotel, and then nothing happens. And so whatever Jeffrey Hazlitt does for you guys, I mean, just think of him as Christ coming to earth for all entrepreneurs.
Oh, my goodness.
You have no idea. You have no idea. I have holes in my hands and holes in my feet from hanging on the cross.
I told you we're not politically correct.
Hanging on the cross so many times.
I need to save this clip right now. Remember that wristband, what would Jesus do? Now is what would Jeff do? That's what we just switched it to. Right?
So Jeffrey, let's talk about podcast versus YouTube.
Yeah. That's a good one.
How do they work together?
You know, a lot of people go to YouTube, but you go to YouTube, you know, quite frankly, if you're talking about business, let's focus on business, because that's what I focus on. And that's a good portion of what you do as well. When was the last time you rushed to YouTube to watch a business show or why you ran to YouTube to get business advice? And that typically doesn't happen. You don't capture the audience there. It's a good place to park your stuff. And if you want to get tens of views or tens of listens, knock yourself out. Okay. You know, but if you want to add zeros to that, you've got to go to where the people are, and the people are in podcasts. The people are in an Apple, Roku, they're on streaming. And so that's indeed what C-Suite TV and C-Suite Radio does. We take it to where the people are. So, you know, like I have, we have television shows that are on United, on Swoop Air, on the numerous other airlines around the country, in cruise ships. And we're going to where people are, right? And we're on Apple and Roku and Amazon Fire. And we're on smart TVs for the TV side, because that's where you're watching. I don't rush home to watch a primetime business show. Okay. I've got to be in those engines or streaming devices. And the same thing with podcasts. You know, we've taken lots of content off of YouTube and put it in the podcast world and watch it just explode.
Which is what you're doing with Rich Dad.
Yeah. We're doing with your show as well. And you've had some great content because people led you down that path and said, this is where you got to do it. This is where you got to do it. And when you didn't know the alternative, well, it looked like a great idea. But once you know the alternative and you get smarter and you can, like, just like you move your money from here to something that will gain you money over here, that's what we do with content. So it's about getting the content to the right people. And again, not worrying about, oh, I'm going to have a, you know, like, oh, I'm going to be as funny as a cat video, right? You know, that's not going to happen. You know, you're not going to get those kinds of numbers, but you're going to get the numbers you want.
And in terms of content, Jeffrey, is there some content that's trending more than others in the podcast world?
Oh, anytime you can be of value to someone, that's what trends. And the other thing I'm going to jump in on, because a lot of people say about TV or video or about podcast, oh, it needs to be short. It needs to be more condensed. And that's not the case. You know, oh, it needs to only be 2 or 3 minutes because of this. Listen, when was the last time you binge watched Downton Abbey or Yellowstone or whatever it might be? You'll sit down and listen to an entire season, just like they will do for you. If they come upon you and say, oh my gosh, I love this show, they'll go back and listen to all 255 episodes.
Okay.
Over time. And that's what you want.
One question. What's going to happen to major networks? ABC, NBC, CBS.
Going away. I mean, look at what major networks used to be. Let's take ABC, for instance. Great example. Back in ABC's heyday, let's take Happy Days. A great night on Happy Days was how many viewers in one night? 60 million. Now let's fast forward to today. One of the most popular shows ever, The Big Bang Theory, right? I love that show. Everybody loves that show. Do you know what their biggest night of viewership was for that show? 6 million. 6 million. So it's the numbers aren't going up for them. They're going down. And that method of being able to go and watch it during this time and that time, it's just done. It's over. And it's just a matter of time. It's just a matter of time. So there's power in these micro networks. There's power in these subject matter networks that we're creating and getting people to the right things the way they like to listen.
So this is similar to Eastman Kodak.
Oh, totally. It's so apropos. And I saw that then, and we tried to do what we could, but it's tough to move a massive ship like that to get it to. And then, of course, we hit 2008, and it was like, oh my gosh, we just walked into massive headwinds at that time.
But as you said, also the culture of Kodak was our best days are behind us. Really hard to make headway when that's the mindset.
And, and quite frankly, I mean, here's a good saying with that too. I used to tell people, they say, hey, and they actually would say this to me, Jeff, make us cool again. And you can't be cool and dress like Elmer Fudd. I mean,
Jeffrey, I worked for Xerox.
Oh yeah.
And they were both in Rochester.
Yeah. And right across the river.
We made so much fun of the Kodak guys.
Yeah.
They did dress like Elmer Fudd.
Yeah.
That's amazing.
Amazing. Robert, when I walked into my office, I had a suite of offices, mahogany offices, I had my own jet plane, the whole bit, everything, right? All the trappings of corporate. And my office had shag carpet. Literally had shag carpet. I swear to God.
I hope it was green and orange.
It was green. It was green.
There you go.
It was that dark green shag carpet.
Hey, Jeffrey, nobody understands what we're talking about. We're so old, they have no idea what you guys are talking about.
By the way, I ripped up that carpet because that's the kind of guy I am, and I found marble floors underneath.
Oh my God.
In the hallway. So I ripped up all the entire carpet of the entire floor one weekend by myself, stacked it. And then I went and bought a buffer and I buffed the floors. Okay. And beautiful marble floors. I mean, I'm a take charge kind of guy. So that's what I did. There's a whole long story behind that, but yeah, that's what I did.
Hey, Jeffrey, we're out of time, but man, I tell you.
This has been fantastic. You're creating so much opportunity for people, especially in these times when they're tough times and people are having wake-up calls. You're giving them so much opportunity to move forward in the world.
Well, I
thank you for that.
Giving. Quite frankly, in the end, it's all about giving. The more you give, the more you get. And
correct.
So for all of us, it's about how we come together and help each other. And from that, we can do something a lot bigger.
Right. Yes. Jeffrey, thank you. You're
the
best.
You,
everybody, I want to let you know, he's turned our podcast business up. I mean, profitable, profitable, profitable. So please contact C-Suite. Once again, we'll be right back, and we'll have the final words from Rich Dad Radio. Jeffrey, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Jeffrey.
Thank you. I'm blessed.
I really have had a lump in my stomach thinking about the loss of our freedom of speech.
Let's change that.
We'll fix it.
We'll fix that.
Yeah. Thank you. Welcome back, Robert Kiyosaki, the Rich Dad Radio Show, the good news and bad news about money. And I really want to thank Jeffrey Hazlett, Chairman and CEO of C-Suite. That was one of the best shows. I mean, I've had a knot in my stomach ever since this thing on censorship. You know, it's just the freedom of speech. That is a basic freedom. And it's been taken away. So to talk to him just now, I just feel like a relief. It's just a relief. And so once again, listen to Rich Dad Radio anytime on iTunes, Android, YouTube, and now C-Suite. But anyway, because I don't know anything. I'm an old guy. You know, I still remember shag carpet. Most people don't know even what that stuff is. But anyway, and you can listen to this program again on Rich Dad Radio. We archive it. It's a podcast. And then you can review it, listen to it. You listen to it again, you'll pick up even more. But most importantly, if you're an entrepreneur, you know, I would look into the offerings that C-Suite has for you, because it is the future. He is talking about the future, bypassing, you know, ABC, NBC, CBS, MSNBC, and all those other criminal nations, which I'll probably get delisted for that one. But anyway, I want to thank Jeffrey House. Any comments, Kim?
Yeah, I love what Jeffrey said, too, because this whole censorship has been so frustrating and even more than that. But what he said is the media that's going to succeed, the media that's trusted, and the podcasts give people an alternative to all these other networks out there. It gives you an alternative, and it actually gives you a way to grow your business in a fantastic way where you can get your message out. And he said the content the content that wins is the content that adds value. If you can add value to your audience, then you will win. So, I mean, those are just basic values of life and tenets of life, and I like that.
And I like what he said also. We need to be, you know, he needs to be responsible what is being said on the air and all this, but don't censor people. There's a big difference. You know, if you're showing porno doggy shows or whatever you're doing, you know, I mean, your audience is going to tell you, we don't like it. You know, but I don't know the censorship stuff. Any comments, Sarah?
Yeah, I think to that point, he was saying, you know, he may not agree with kneeling or burning a flag or whatever, but he will defend everybody's right to do so. And I think that's missing in America right now, is defending our right to.
I think maybe because they've gone so far and people are really, really getting fed up, we are going to start looking for alternatives and we're going to start creating ways to get our message out there.
You want to tell them about the game, why it was censored? Our cash flow game is censored.
On one of our platforms, we have a cash flow game advertising and we put ads out for it and all of a sudden it got taken down. And we're like, how did the game get taken down? And it was for offensive language. And we're like, offensive language? We're selling a board game. So we went back to the company and we're going through it. And why they took it down is because in our copy, it says, as an investor, some investors are conservative and some investors are risk takers. Because we use the word conservative, they took us down. That is censorship. And that is stupid because it wasn't even the meaning of the word. I mean, it is getting so ridiculous that,
knot in my stomach comes and says, you know, conservative? What else am I saying that's offensive to you? I mean, I just can't believe it. Anyway, I really want to thank Jeffrey Hazard. Great job there, Sarah, getting him on. And
great show.
If you have a chance, please contact C-Suite.net and find out what they offer for you. So anyway, thank you all for listening to Rich Dad Radio Show. See you next time.
Thank you.